Brent and Jen, that woman tells us she wishes police would have taken Peter Recchia into custody that night so he still wouldn't be missing.
When I saw him on TV, I jumped up. I was like, oh my gosh, yes, that's the guy. That's him. That's who came into our house.
Anita Cabrera says missing Middletown man Peter Recchia broke into her Hampton home on October 3rd, wearing the exact outfit Middletown police described in Recchia's Silver Alert issued last Tuesday.
I saw his daughter on TV, and she's, you know, you could see the pain of, you know, nervousness of not his, her father is missing. It made me a little bit more upset with how the whole situation was dealt with.
Cabrera says Recchia was harmless when he broke in at 4 a.m. Nonetheless, she called Hampton police.
And that's when he started preaching and saying, oh, thank God, we're saved, we're saved. God saved us.
But police were able to locate Recchia that night, although they did not take him into custody, something Cabrera doesn't agree with.
They knew, they said, oh, you know, they knew that he had some, you know, he wasn't well. So to help him, they should have taken him in that night, is how we feel. And it just made us so upset that, you know, they didn't do that.
Cabrera says police told her they didn't take Recchia into custody because she didn't state she wanted to press charges.
So my mom's really sad because she waits for him every day to come.
Bunny Rodriguez, Recchia's daughter, says her father does suffer from mental illness and visited the hospital twice during the week he disappeared. This new video shows Recchia walking along Main Street in Durham back on Wednesday, October 2nd.
I just feel like my dad is somewhere between Middletown and Durham, and we need help finding him.
Rodriguez says Middletown detectives are now working with Hampton police to locate her father, but still need the public's help. Live in Middletown tonight, Zania Maldonado, Fox 61 News.